वन दिस इज अनिल दवालिया और स्टार्ट करते हैं एम जीके की जो सीरीज है उसका लेक्चर 9। आज इसमें अपन 14-15 करंट अफेयर्स के बहुत लेटेस्ट क्वेश्चंस को डिस्कस करने वाले हैं, ठीक है। और लास्ट वीडियो में मैंने आपको एक क्वेश्चन दिया था कि जिसका आंसर टेलीनोर था, 95% बच्चों ने उसका आंसर करेक्ट किया, बट फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर हु हैड मार्क आंसर एज रिलायंस जियो और समथिंग एल्स। सो प्लीज नोट डाउन द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन वॉज टेलीनोर। Telenor has merged with Bharti Airtel. Okay, let's start this video. Before starting this video, I'll tell you I'm verified educator at Unacademy. I have made 24 courses with 250 plus videos. You can follow me on Unacademy for more videos. I have uploaded entire chemistry over there. You can watch my lessons of chemistry for especially for the IIMS and JIPMER exam. You can learn lots of concepts from that particular videos. For more videos, you can follow me on Unacademy. So I hope they will do. I'll show you a few lessons over there that I have made. That is the entire organic chemistry with most expected question. As you see the blue tick that I'm verified. Similarly, the organic chemistry, these chemistry videos are really very helpful for the AIIMS as well as JIPMER examination. So today's topic is current affairs. So we will discuss lots of current affair question. The first question is, which bank has recently imposed ₹50,000 penalty on the Reserve Bank of India? The name of that particular bank who has imposed that penalty on Reserve Bank of India is Universal Cooperative Bank. This similar question has been asked in different way. They may ask, Universal Cooperative Bank has imposed a penalty of ₹50,000 on which bank? So on that time you have to pick the answer, Reserve Bank of India. So I would suggest to you ki please read the question carefully what they are asked to you. Now move to the second question. Recently, according to the report released by the World Bank, how many jobs are required for every year in India? As you can see, there are lots of unemployment in India. So according to the recent report released by the World Bank, they have estimated around 80 lakh new jobs are required every year in India. Okay, so this is again a factual question, so you have to remember this thing, 80 lakh. Now the third question, but for this, recently according to the report released by the United Nations in 2018-19, India's economic growth rate is estimated to be 7.6%. This data, you have to remember this thing. I don't know whether you have read the newspaper or you likes to read the newspaper, so no need to worry about it. I'll cover each and every current affairs, what were the possible questions, I'll cover in that particular video. Recently, move to the next question. Recently, the Prime Minister laid the foundation of India's longest road tunnel, Jojila Tunnel, has a length of 14 kilometers. Please remember, recently the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji, laid the foundation of India's longest road tunnel. Please remember this thing, road tunnel. And name of that road tunnel is Jojila Tunnel, and which is of length of 14 kilometers. Okay, please remember this thing. Now the next question, who was elected as the new chairman of Coal India Limited, CIL? The new chairman is Anil Kumar Jha. He has been appointed as the new chairman of the Coal India Limited. Now move to the next question. This is the very famous question. As you see, you may have seen the news on elections, Karnataka elections. So you may directly tick the answer. I hope all of you are aware about this thing. Who recently resigned from the post of Chief Minister after 2 days. He is none other than B.S. Yediyurappa. Okay, now move to the next question. Who recently became the youngest woman in India to climb Mount Everest from Nepal? Okay, this thing is again important. Recently, she became the youngest woman in India to climb Mount Everest from Nepal. She is Shivangi Pathak. Okay, Shivangi Pathak. Now the next question. Which country's Prime Minister will be on a 2-day Indian tour this week? From which country the Prime Minister is coming in India for a 2-day trip? So he's Prime Minister of Russia. So that particular country from Russia, the Prime Minister is coming this week in India for a 2-day Indian tour. Okay, please remember this thing. As we all know, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he visited lots of countries. Now this time the Russian Prime Minister coming to India. Now the next question for this particular series is, which state introduced the free treatment scheme for the road accident victims? Recently, Gujarat state has introduced this free treatment scheme for the road accident victims. So please remember this thing. They may have you have other options like Haryana, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh. So please remember this thing. On the Gujarat state, they have released this scheme. Now the next question for this thing is Ram Lingam Sudhakar sworn in as the new Chief Justice of High Court. Of which High Court? Manipur High Court. Please remember this also. This is the Manipur High Court. Okay, now move to the next question. Next question says, who was elected as Vice President of Badminton Asia Federation? This is again a current affair question. So you have to take the answer as Himanta Biswa Sharma. Himanta Biswa Sharma was elected as the Vice President of the Badminton Asia Federation. Okay, who was appointed as the first woman? Dekho, actually in the AIIMS or any exam where GK has been asked, they may ask only these types of questions. On the current affairs, who was the first one? Recently, what is going on in that particular field? The logos, important logos. I'll make next video on some important logos. Okay. Now this particular question, come back to the particular question. Who was appointed as the first woman director of the Central Intelligence Agency, CIA? Geena Haspel. Geena Haspel has appointed as the first woman director of the Central Intelligence Agency. Okay, now move to the next question. I hope everyone have learned lot of things from this particular video. Next question says, the Supreme Court has approved a new scheme for the central government on the management of the water of which river? Kaveri River. Okay, this thing is again important. Now I'll bit explain more about the Kaveri River. Kaveri River also referred as Punni, P-O-N-N-I, Punni. Kaveri River also referred as Punni is an Indian river flowing through the states of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Okay, it is the third largest after Godavari and Krishna in South India. Please remember this thing. Kaveri is the third largest after Godavari and Krishna in South India. And the largest in Tamil Nadu. Okay, these are the some important things about Kaveri. You may have this thing, Kaveri dispute. Okay, so it's the same rivers. Sometimes it may written as C-A-U-V-E-R-Y. Okay, but here I have spelled as K-A-V-E-R-I. Okay, both are the same things. Now move to the next thing. The governor of the Gujarat has been given additional charge of which state? He has given an additional charge of Madhya Pradesh. Okay, these are the few important current affairs that I have tried to cover in this entire video, around 14 to 15 current affairs question, latest current affairs question I tried to cover in that particular video. I hope this video is very helpful for your AIIMS exam, upcoming AIIMS exam. If you need more current affairs, please subscribe to my channel, Anirudh Walia's channel. Till now, I have uploaded GK lectures, which includes current affairs questions, static GK, aptitude questions. And also I have said to you, for more aptitude questions, you can watch my bit set reasoning videos. In that particular videos, I have covered entirely aptitude questions. So you may refer those videos that I have made for bit set examination. Okay, so till now, please watch this lecture 1 to 9. This will be very, very helpful for your upcoming AIIMS exam. I wish all the best to all the aspirants. In the next video, we'll discuss more about current affairs plus static questions. So stay tuned for more videos. Meet in the next video. God bless you all. Tata. Bye-bye.